The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 10th chapter, text number 4 and 5, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in January of 1967 in New York.
Buddhi jnanam asana moha sama satyam dama samaha sukham dukham bhavo abhavo bhayancha abhayam abhayameva. So you have to understand these qualifications. Intelligence, buddhi means intelligence, jnanam means knowledge, asanga moha means freedom from illusion. Sama, forgiveness. Satyam, truth. Dama means controlling the senses. And sama, to keep the mind equibalanced. Sukham means happiness. Dukham, distress. Bhava means birth. Abhava means death. Bhayam, fear, and abhayam, fearlessness. Ahimsa, non-violence. Samata, equality. Tusti, satisfaction. Tapa, penance. Dana, charity. Jasa, fame. Ajasa, defamation. Bhavanti, all these become bhava. Bhava means state of being. Bhutana, of all living entities. Mattaha, from me. Eva, certainly, prithak vidha, different. Because Krishna has declared already, aham adihi devanam mahasnancha sarva. He is the original cause of everything. Now, then he must be the cause of all good qualification and bad qualification also. Whatever we see in this material world, we consider this is bad and this is good. We are divided according to our calculation. But actually there are varied manifestations of the qualities of Krishna. In here, in the material world, those qualities, transcendental qualities, they are in Krishna and they are in living entities. Just like we have all these qualities. Take for example, buddhi. Buddhi means intelligence. And what is that intelligence? Real intelligence. Real intelligence is to know, to understand that Krishna is the Supreme and I am part and parcel. It is stated here that intelligence means sukhartha vivacana samatyam. Suppose one is very intelligent to drive a car. That is material intelligence for earning our bread. Real intelligence is sukhartha, the finer sentiment to understand the finer activities of nature. That is called buddhi, to understand how things are happening. Just like one is considered to be intelligent when he tries to understand not this physiological or anatomical construction of this body. He wants to see by intelligence what is the active principle of this body that is working. That is intelligence. Not that just like a child. A child sees that a nice motor car runs in the street. He thinks that the motor car is running out of its own accord. Oh, that is not intelligent. The motor car is not running in spite of it. Just like here we have got this tape recorder, this microphone. Oh, somebody may say, oh, how fine discoveries are these, they are working so nicely. But one should see that this tape recorder or this microphone cannot work for a single moment unless a spirit soul touches. This is intelligence. We should not be wonderful by seeing a machine. We should try to find out who is working the machine. That is it. Sukhartavivachanam, to see the fine. Grossly seeing, that is not interesting. Man is working, man is living, man is writing books. Oh, wonderfully, he is scientist. But what that finer things that at once it is vanished, the scientist becomes fool. No more scientist. Then scientists discover something and place it before a student that when my body will be stopped, you inject these things, then I will come out of it. Has scientists discovered this thing? No. If scientists could discover such things, then there would have been no scarcity of scientists. Sir Isaac Newton, Sir Jagadish Chandra Bose, Sir P.C. Rai, and so many scientists all over the world, they have discovered very, very, in your country, edition, they have discovered so many wonderful things. Oh, then why don't you, oh Mr. Scientist, why don't you discover something so that we can keep it as soon as your body will be stopped and we shall inject this scientific and you come out again and work. So this is called intelligence. The scientist is working, the philosopher is working, not out of his own effort. It is working under the spell of material nature. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, you find prakita kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasah ahankar vimuratma kattaham iti mannate. Prakiti, by nature's law, is working. Why not everybody, scientist? Why not everybody, if it is accidental, if it is automatic, why there are so many differences? Here is a scientist, here is a fool. Why? Why this distinction? The distinction is made by prakriti, by nature. And what is this prakriti? That prakriti is Mahadhasena prakriti sriyate sa saracharam. Oh, Krishna says, under my direction this prakriti is working. The prakriti, nature is the agent. Real worker is Krishna. We are simply instruments. That is our position. If you have got intelligence, then you have to understand that you are simply an instrument. Just like my hand. What is this hand? This is an instrument. I can pick up. So I am working, not this hand is working. I am working. So people do not understand. Ahankara Vimuratma. By false ego, he is thinking, oh, I am scientist. Oh, I am philosopher. I am Rockefeller. I am businessman. I am Sami. I am this. Sometimes he thinks I am poor. I am this and that. No. You are simply instrument in the hands of Krishna. That is intelligence. Therefore, you should work as Krishna desires. That is real intelligence. If you work in Krishna consciousness, that is real intelligence. And if you work against Krishna, that is foolishness. That is the distinction between intelligence and foolishness. Jnanam. Jnanam means knowledge. Now, so far knowledge is concerned, here is a key packet. If you want to make research, who has made this packet, who has discovered it, in which country first it was introduced, in what material it is made, or you can write volumes of books. You can speculate in any damn thing, and you can write volumes of books. That does not mean that you are a man of knowledge. There are so many. I'll give you one very nice example. This is practical. In my youthhood, I was manager in a big chemical park. So there was a sulfuric acid chamber. There was some defect. It was not working well. In that chamber, sulfur is given and it is fused and then acid comes out. So it was not working. So there were many scientists, they are sitting, consulting, why it is not working? Then the managing director, Dr. Bose, he was a very intelligent man. He at once went to another farm. They are also chemical. So he knew there was an ordinary worker. He was very experienced. So he was a marvelous. He called him at once. Just come and see. What is this here? And he at once came and manipulated some machine. At once acid control. All the theoretical scientists, they sat down. So this kind of experience you will find even in ordinary man, and even in bird, you will find they have got some sort of specific intelligence or knowledge. That is not knowledge. You will find even in animals there are some wonderful activities which you cannot perform. That is not knowledge. Knowledge means to understand spirit and matter. That is knowledge. What is spirit, what is matter? Just like after intellectual research you find that there is something within this body which is working, without which this body is useless. Then when you come to knowledge that this is this and this is that, when you understand that this is spirit and this is matter. Matter is working due to the touch of the spirit. Just like I have already explained that this tape recorder, this microphone is working because a boy who is spirit soul, he has touched it. Without touching. So therefore we must distinguish. So what is matter and the spirit? Matter cannot work without touch of spirit. Matter is dependent on spirit. This is knowledge. Not that matter is prominent and spirit is neglected. That is foolishness. Therefore, in the present day education, there is hardly a few persons who are actually in knowledge because they have neglected the spirit side of the activity. They have taken only the material side of the activity. So if you come So according to the Bhagavad Gita, then it is a civilization of fools, but because they are giving too much stress on the motor car, machine, and not to the driver. The driver is neglected. This is foolish civilization. Man is neglected. I think in my childhood, when I was a student, Scottish Baptist College, I read one magazine from your country. I think that magazine is still current, Scientific America. Is that any magazine?
Yes.
In magazine, I saw one picture. The skyscraper was beginning at that time. A man was working very heartily, and the picture is that for manufacturing matter, a soul is the key. That is material civilization. They are giving too much stress on the matter, on the material side, but they are neglecting the spirit. That is not civilization. One should give more stress on the spiritual side, because that is the active principle. So that is called knowledge. A man is to be understood in knowledge when he is giving importance to the spiritual side. He is called jnana. Otherwise they are fools. So jnana. Jnana means chid achid vastu viritram, to understand what is matter and spirit. A civilized, real advanced civilization, the Aryans are called advanced. The actual meaning of Aryan means advanced, according to Sanskrit. This is Aryan is not English word or Hebrew or any other language. It is the Sanskrit word, Aryan, Arya, Arya. The word comes from the Arya, A-R-Y-A, Arya. Now, it has become a common word, Aryan, but it is originally the Sanskrit word. And Arya means one who is advanced, or one is civilized, one who knows, one has knowledge. Then he is called Arya. In the Bhagavad Gita, you find when Arjuna declined to fight, Krishna condemned him. Oh, you are just like talking like a non-Aryan. Not Aryan. So, we all belong to the Aryan family, and we have historical references here, Indo-European family. So, Aryan stock was in Central Asia. Some of them migrated to India, some of them migrated to Europe. And from Europe you have come. So we belong to the Aryan family, but we have lost our knowledge. So we have become non-Aryan, practically, because we do not give importance to the spiritual side of life. The Aryan means one who gives importance to the spiritual side of life. And what is that importance? The spiritual side importance giving means one has to see how much important this human life is. Because in the human form of life, the spirit soul, although it is conditioned by material and engagement, it has developed its consciousness by gradual evolution. This evolution theory is there in the Padma Purana. There is actual evolution from lower, status of life, beginning from the aquatic small, plant life, then germs life, then birds life, then beast life, then human form of life, then civilized human form of life. So fortunately, we have got now civilized form of life. The Aryan family means they are civilized form of life. But we are utilizing in the matter of maintaining this body. Ahara nidra bhaya maitananta. We are utilizing this material, this developed body of spirit, the spirit soul has got the chance now to liberate himself. There is a process by nature where the evolution is to give chance to spirit to get out of this spirit and spiritual material entanglement. The people are not giving importance. Therefore, we sometimes find there is overpopulation. Overpopulation. What is this overpopulation? Overpopulation means that just like from lower class, a student is promoted, and when he comes to the final class, if he does not pass, then the class is overcome. Suppose from 1, 2, 3, 4, one comes to the 10th class. 10th class is meant for final examination and go to the college. So if in the 10th class the student fails, then the 10th class becomes populated, overpopulated. Similarly, the present civilization, we sometimes find that there is overpopulation. Overpopulation, we are not being promoted to higher life. We are being blocked. And therefore, nature's course is there must be some pestilence, there must be some war to finish it. So there is no such intelligence, there is no such knowledge, and we are very much proud. You see, once really, because these things are God-gave knowledge, it is explained here, buddhi jnanam asanga moha. All these things are gifts of God, so we must utilize. This human form is developed for utilizing the gifts of God. God has given us nice food stuff, God has given us intelligence, and God has given us knowledge. Now, God has given us books of knowledge. He is personally speaking, this Bhagavad Gita. Why don't you utilize it? Why don't you utilize it? If we utilize it, then we may be proud of become alien or human being. But if we don't utilize these things, simply we follow the animal propensity. Just like a dog is after a lady dog. Similarly, if you are like that. Just like a hog is after a female hog. So this is not civilization. We must be sober. We must be sober, we must be distinct from animal life. That is called utilization of human form of life. Labdha sudullama midam. It is stated in the Vedic literature that labdha sudullama midam bahu sambhavante. This body is achieved after many, 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 many births, after millions and trillions of years. Because you don't think that all of us happened by accident, well, we have got this body. There are other bodies, cats, dogs, and so many bodies. Why in this two-life form? There must have been some process. So this is said in the Vedic literature. Labdha sudullavamidam bahusambhavanti manushyam arthadam. This human form of life is achieved after many, many millions of other forms of birth. And what is this form? Manushyam, human form. Man, this manushyam is Sanskrit word. And English word man, there is similarity, Latin. Originally this manushyam or man comes from the word manu. Manu is the father of humankind. The manushyam. So, why it is so rare? The arthadam. He can attain the highest perfection. Arthadam. Artha means money or artha means substance. Arthadam So we are utilizing it for money making. Artha means money also, but there is another meaning of artha. Artha means substance. We are missing the substance, we are attracted by material money only. So manasam arthadam, anittam apiha dhira, and anittam, although arthadam, it can deliver you the substance, but it is not permanent. Anittam. Anittam means, nittam means eternal, permanent, anittam means just the opposite. So, the scripture advises you, manasam arthadam apiha dhira. But if you are dhira, dhira means sober, intelligence, then how you shall utilize it? Turnam jateta anumastupateta javat. You should try to utilize this human form of life to achieve the highest substance. Very soon. Turnam means very soon. Why very soon? Now anumastupateta javat. You do not know when your death will come. You do not know. So before death comes, just utilize yourself. Don't think that I am a young man. Oh, let me enjoy now, if be merry and enjoy. No. You should not neglect. Prahlad Maharaj, a 5-year-old boy, he was instructed by Narada Muni, he became a very great devotee. And he was instructing his class fellow when he was a 5-year-old boy. Because it doesn't matter whether he is a 5-year-old boy or 500-year-old tree. There is no utilization of becoming 500-year-old tree or 5 million-year stone. That's no utilization. If you become a 5-year-old boy and if you understand this knowledge, your life is perfect. These things are all very nicely discussed. They say, Tarava kimna jivanti. You are very much proud of your long duration of life. Because you see the cats and dogs die within 10 years or 20 years and you live 70 years or 80 years, therefore you are very much proud. The answer is Tarava kimna jivanti. Don't you see the tree? It lives 500 years, 1,000 years. Tree lives, but it cannot breathe. Vatsa kimna sasantati. Don't you see the bellow? A bag of skin. Mass, it is breathing. So, do you think your breathing is very a smartness? Well, they breathe, but they cannot enjoy sex life. The dogs and horses, they do not enjoy sex life. Do they not eat? In this way, there is analysis. There is analysis. Regular analysis. What for you are so much proud? The proudness should be proved when you are in Krishna consciousness. That is the perfection of it. Otherwise, you are cats and dogs. Don't take it that I am criticizing it. Just I am analyzing the fact. So, this should be utilized. This is called intelligence. This is called jnana. This is called free from bewilderment. These are the process. So if we study Bhagavad Gita nicely, analytically, synthetically, in every way, with our intelligence, we have got intelligence, we have got reason, then we become perfect man. This is Krishna consciousness. Take advantage of it. Don't spoil your life. That is our request. The society is for that purpose. We are not bluffing anybody. That make exercise and go home. No. Here is something substantial. Try to understand. Thank you.